So here's a lick idea, maybe a couple of them, for going from the B7 to the E minor. One of the things that I like to use is to use the diminished seventh triad. Let me just lay down the B7 to the E minor a few times, and I'll do it a little bit slowly, so if you want to practice along. So as long as you end on a chord tone, you can mess around all day long with that diminished seventh lick and come up with your own licks. And of course, as you know by now, that is my mantra for you and for me too. Be creative with the material. Take, for example, this is like the letters of the alphabet. You're taking the letters of the alphabet and then you're having a conversation. You're not thinking too much about the letters, like for example, much is spelled M-U-C-H. I did not think that when I just said much a couple seconds ago. It's kind of like that. You are after learning this material to the point where you can be more fluid with it. So the idea that I just did, I'll give it to you so you can have something to practice. I started, instead of starting on the C, so starting on that C, you certainly can. I started on the B a couple times. So starting on the B because it's a B7 chord. Or going from the top. Either of those two ideas is a very nice way to go into the tonic chord, the E minor. So what I'm doing is I'm going up the diminished seventh, the whole thing, starting on the C instead of the D sharp, although you could start anywhere. And then I'm doing it again, but starting on the next note up. And then doing it again. Now I chose that specifically because when I do that pattern, I end on the D sharp and going from the D sharp to the E is very satisfying. So that is just one idea among many that you can use just for the B7 going to the E. Mess around with that diminished seventh triad, seventh chord, diminished seventh chord, those four notes, and you will find all kinds of pleasing ways to get from the B7 to the E. All right, good luck.